I think so far as education is concerned, there's a reasonable amount of traction in college education, and particularly engineering education, because quite a lot of engineering education is really privatized, so there is an incentive to set up new colleges of a reasonably high quality. But if you talk about primary education, particularly primary education in the villages of India, secondary education in the villages of India, is being completely a disaster situation. Not enough is being done. What is being done is not being well executed on the ground floor. And I think it's leading to a fairly serious situation, which is why we as a foundation have been so involved in it for the past 10 years with a single-minded focus in primary education in the villages of India. I'm particularly optimistic about India's future, and I attribute that to the entrepreneurship of India, to an extremely vibrant democracy, which is across all levels of education. And I think that's fundamental to a successful society in the long run. So whatever aberrations you see now, whatever issues on governance which you're seeing now, which are hitting the press and hitting the media, I think is something which is in a way good, because it's been a major wake-up call for the people. It's been a major wake-up call for the government. And any government which has to get re-elected every 5 years, this particular government has to get elected in little over 2 years, has to be sensitive to that. But they must have an implementation machinery for that, an honest implementation machinery, and an accountable machinery which has consequences. I think one of the nice things about the UID program, which is the identification program, is that it can potentially convert all sorts of subsidies into a payment of cash to the housewife of the house. And then she goes with these cash vouchers to any shop and chooses what she wants to get on it, up to a certain limit that she's entitled to because her family is below the poverty line. And one of the good things of the governance information technology progress which is being made across all the states is that it reduces individual judgments. And that is now penetrating and is being replicated state after state. So far as the common man is concerned, there is a high possibility that in the next 3 years, 2.5 years, a lot of the hassle he or she goes through can be significantly mitigated if the government is sincere. And poverty is defined just as not economic poverty. Poverty is defined by way of education. Poverty is defined by way of health. But the things today are certainly better. And you see that in rapidly increasing rural demand in the country, in towns and villages below 15,000 population, 10,000 population. That cannot be happening unless there is wealth being created at a grassroots level in the villages of India. So I think in terms of some of the programs of government, in terms of the consumerism which is spreading, in terms of higher realization for the farmer, in terms of more job opportunities, I think it is penetrating, and the government could be doing it better, but I think it is to their credit that they have done a reasonably good job on that. Or China will have to adopt some form of modified Chinese democracy. But I think the advantage of democracy, it makes us less dependent on a group of leaders. It's a more broad-based way of getting consensus in the way the country goes forward. And for India, it has been a positive thing. And it has certainly broad-based the amount of participation the voters can make in the running of the country or the destiny of the country. And it's inherent to human desire. I don't think any country in the world can hold it back beyond a point of time. And you're seeing this experience in the Middle East. Wipro is doing well, but I think we'll do much better going in the future.
Because?
We have made some transformational changes. We have made changes in leadership, in terms of succession, in terms of leadership, in terms of the way we have simplified the business, made it faster on the feet, and we are starting to see results of it happening now. We have built up Europe successfully. We have built up the Middle East successfully. We have built up Australia successfully. We're now building up Latin America and Africa successfully. So we have now a broad portfolio of risk diversification. You know, the United States is a complex country. It's a country which has also got a very high predominance of immigrants, and it has a huge attraction to the talent of the world to come down here, settle down here, and take on citizenships. So it's an extremely fertile country for innovation, for initiatives.